Get Ready With Me, anyone? It's very rare when I start a video with a bare face, nothing on, but today's one of those days I really just want to get ready with you guys and talk you through my look and exactly what I got planned for my day. So today I'm gonna be attending my very first beauty event of 2021, and it's gonna be on the beach with a very small group. I think there's only six of us, so it's gonna be very intimate. The location is in Malibu. It's gonna be around sunset. So I wanted to show you guys how I'm gonna get this entire look. The focus is gonna be on a softer eye, but a very radiant, glowy finish on the skin. We are gonna be mixing quite a few products because this little mixture of products that I have is really amazing. I've been rocking it lately. It's a tinted moisturizer, a foundation, and a concealer. I have this way that I've been placing it lately. So I wanna show you guys how I do it, show you guys all the products I'm gonna be using, and just overall how to get the look for today. So if you guys love these kind of videos, a sit down, get ready with me, chatty, but also informative, teaching at the same time, give the video a thumbs up. Also, if you guys are not subscribed, please subscribe to my channel. I do beauty, hair, cooking, drinking. We do a little bit of everything on this channel, so definitely join the party. It's a good time on here. So with that being said, let's go ahead and get into today's video. So the number one most important step for this makeup look is to have your skin completely bare of any products and have it clean. The preparation in your skin is super important and a step that I feel like sometimes us YouTubers or beauty creators, beauty influencers don't sometimes explain enough, but it is important to prep your skin before you get into your makeup. That way things can lay on nicely. The makeup lasts longer. When you're mixing different formulas, different textures, you want everything to kind of lay nicely. And if you don't prep your skin, it's not going to do that. Please be aware that everyone's skin is so different. People may have texture, people may have different problem areas, but as for me, what has worked is the preparation of my skin. So I just had microneedling done about a week ago, and I went in today for my follow-up facial, and they exfoliate all the excess dead skin that's sitting on there. What that does is reveal obviously brighter, smoother, radiant skin, and they took off a lot of like the patchiness that was left. I was peeling all week. So I'm not gonna be doing any exfoliating on my skin on camera, but if you're recreating this look at home, and you want to know how you can exfoliate, obviously you can use a physical one, but personally I recommend doing a peel like this. This is from Dr. Dennis Gross. It is the alpha beta peel, the two-step system. The first step is going to exfoliate and smooth, and the second step is going to neutralize, and it's also anti-aging. So the reason I like this is because it's a chemical exfoliator, so it goes a little deeper into the skin, helps to smooth the skin, brighten it, also removes any dead skin cells that are kind of sitting in certain areas. This is like a holy grail product I would use the day of my wedding, before I go on red carpet, somewhere where I just want my skin to look brighter and fresh and radiant. So because I had a microdermabrasion today, I'm not gonna be using this, but if I didn't have that, this is definitely the first step I would do into my skin to really reveal that bomb smooth skin. So just want to explain that to you guys really quickly because this is very important. So now that we have that done, I'm gonna go ahead and apply some serum on, and I'm gonna be using this one from Josie Moran. It is the Argan Bright Skin Vitamin C. I have like nothing left, honestly. Do you guys see that? You probably can't even see it. I have literally nothing left in there. This one is more like an oil. So I'm gonna go ahead and rub it in my hands and then press it into my skin. I know some people aren't always a fan of oil-based products, and if you're not, that's totally fine, but I recommend regardless still using like a vitamin C product to really brighten up the skin. So once I'm done with that and I let it settle in for a little bit, I'm gonna move now into my moisturizer. And what I'm gonna be using today is from Lancome. This is the soft creme. The reason I really like this one for like a daytime look like this is because it goes on like a cream, but as you work it into the skin, it turns into a serum-like lotion. You can see it just kind of melts into the skin. Just a luxurious cream, honestly. Next, I'm gonna go ahead and pop on some eye cream. This one is from Skin Medica. It is the Instant Bright, and I like to add just like a pump, sometimes half a pump, onto my ring finger. I just tap, 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 tap. And then from there, I kind of just work my way up into the temple, brow bone area, and then tap down and then around. So I'm gonna show you guys something that I like to do when I'm getting ready, not necessarily always on camera, but when I'm at home, but I like to get my knuckles like this and just go along my jawline and work up. Do you guys hear that? This is really gonna help out with the lymph node, push the product deeper into the skin. It chisels you as well, right? You could use a gua sha too, but sometimes our own fingers are tools that we can use. Woo! All right, there we go. All right, if you guys end up doing the technique, just know that it will leave you a little red for a few minutes, but it does go down eventually, but it's okay because we're about to get into the complexion part. So now that everything is kind of settled in, we're gonna jump into some primer. Now this is optional, but something that I do recommend adding. I know there's people out there that don't care for it, but for me, I do like it for my problem areas. I am somebody who does have pores that are visible, not too crazy, but I do like to even them out as much as possible. So I'm gonna be using this putty primer from e.l.f. and I'm gonna be adding this on with a foundation brush, and I'm just gonna hit the area that I want to even out. Obviously, this is going to somewhat mattify the skin, so I don't want this all over. It's kind of one in the area where I feel my pores are a little bit more enlarged. So now I'm gonna go ahead and apply on my tinted moisturizer. I'm gonna be using this one from NARS. It is a Pure Radiance Tinted Moisturizer with SPF 30, and this one is in the shade Sydney Medium 1.2. I do also use the Laura Mercier one, which I love using as well. It is the Tinted Moisturizer Oil-Free. I kind of go back and forth between both of these, but since we're going to a NARS event, I figured we would do this one instead so you guys can see how it looks on. So the trick with this one, you gotta roll up your sleeves, so we're about to use our hands, is to apply it on with your hands. And I'm gonna add like that much on there, warm it up, and then just apply on. Now I really like this one because it does have pretty good coverage. It feels like nothing is on your skin. It's like a luminous finish, but it's not oily. Like if you saw me in person, you probably wouldn't even be able to tell that I'm wearing anything on my skin because it's undetectable. Like you can't even see anything at all. It just looks like it's my natural skin, which is why I really like it. And tinted moisturizer is something that I love to wear daily or on days I just need like a quick fix on my skin. This is like perfect to use. Only thing with tinted moisturizers is that if I'm going out, I feel like it's not enough coverage for me. So to add a little bit of coverage while still serving that skin finish, the next step is gonna be to go in with the foundation. Now I saw this tutorial a few months ago and I honestly fell in love with the technique and the way she did this. And this is honestly like the missing key to this. So now what I'm gonna do is go in with my foundation. And this one is the Lorac Pro Soft Focus Longwear in the shade Medium 9. The thing with this is to apply it on with a makeup sponge and just kind of hit the areas that you want that extra coverage. So for me, it is always just right here along the cheek area. So again, tinted moisturizer goes everywhere. The foundation goes just pretty much in the cheek area. So now I'm gonna go in and brighten up my under eyes with some concealer, and I'm gonna be using this one from Too Faced. It's the Born This Way Multi-Use Sculpting Concealer. This is one that's been around for a long time. You guys have seen me use it throughout the years to carve my under eyes. You guys know I love to use chestnut to contour. Like, there's a lot of things about it that I like, but I've never really worn just this underneath of my eyes. And recently I started playing around with it. I don't know why I haven't done it sooner. The reason I like it is first and foremost, like, it has this like big amazing applicator that we're actually not gonna use today, but I like to scoop it out on my hand, and then I'm gonna go in with this flat brush, pretty much just add it where I want to brighten up. But the reason I really love this concealer is first and foremost the coverage. The coverage is amazing. It's I want to say definitely a full. You can make it a medium like if you apply less, but it's more on the full side, but it really covers, it lasts all day, it brightens, you could just do so much with it. And I also love that, like, for example, I'm putting it on like this, I'm gonna let it sit for a few minutes, but when I go and blend it out, it doesn't dry down. I could still move it after it's been sitting for a while. So I love that it blends out really nicely. I'm just now gonna go ahead and add some to the forehead area. I'm just tapping whatever I have left on the brush. We're like really, really, really doing a tutorial today, aren't we? Hope you guys don't mind that. I'm gonna go ahead and let it sit for about a minute or two, and then I'm gonna blend out with my beauty sponge. So I went ahead and started blending out this side, just so you guys can kind of see the difference. By letting it sit for a little bit, I find it to just be easier to blend out. Tapping it pretty much in place, but then also working it up into my temples. Now with this side, I'm gonna go ahead and do the same thing. Just press, tap, tap, tap. I'm telling you guys, this concealer is one of my favorites. It's so easy to blend out. For somebody who doesn't like as much brightness or you don't like as much coverage, you can use whatever you want. Same thing with the forehead area. I'm gonna go ahead and just use the belly of my sponge and then just tap into place, and voila, we're done with the complexion. Not done, but like done with like this part at least. So next we're gonna add some blush onto this look, and this is really going to change this whole look. This is like my favorite blush at the moment, especially for a look like this. It is from EM Cosmetics, and this one is in the shade EM Rose. So this is their color serum blush. It is something that can work great on bare skin or with makeup like this, and it is important to do this step before you move into any kind of powders. So what I'm gonna do is actually just squeeze and then add a few drops onto my cheeks. The finish of this product is probably my favorite because it has color, but it's also very sheer. So I'm gonna tap it with my fingers, and I'm now gonna go ahead and grab this brush and then just tap into place. Overall just gives like gorgeous glow that is so radiant. So this on bare skin is phenomenal. It looks really, really nice, but with makeup, it also looks really pretty as well. Woo, look at the glow. This is what I'm talking about when I say I want like a radiant finish on my skin. I love this so much. Now that we have that on, we're gonna go ahead and set the skin. And I'm pretty much just gonna be setting the under eyes and a little bit of my T-zone area. Now for this look, I do recommend going in with a pretty light powder. So I'm gonna be using this one from Charlotte Tilbury. It is the Airbrush Flawless Finish Skin Perfecting Micro Powder in the shade One Fair. So I'm gonna be using one mainly to set my under eyes and then a little bit on my chin because it is brightening. I'm gonna be using this brush from the Makeup by Ariel X Morphe collab. This is brush A22. And I'm doing this one because it is like a nice fluffy brush, so it's just going to tap and hit those areas. This brush reminds me kind of a duster. Adding a little bit on versus a brush like this, it's a little bit more smaller, it's more compact, it's gonna give you more coverage. So this is just barely adding it on. So now I'm gonna go ahead and add a little bit of setting spray onto my skin. This is an absolute must because we're gonna go ahead and bond all the powder particles together and it's just going to melt into the skin. But now that the complexion part is pretty much done, we're gonna go ahead and do a little bit of baking and then get into the rest of the makeup. So as always, gonna go in with my Laura Mercier Translucent Loose Setting Powder. Pretty much just bake underneath of the eyes. Hit a little bit on my nose. And I figured this is like a great time to get into everything else because the rest of the look is pretty easy after this. I feel like the longest part is honestly just the complexion, like getting that down, but I'm gonna go ahead. Oh, actually, you know what I'm gonna do? I'm actually gonna brighten this area up a little bit. See how the setting spray made it look a little extra glowy again? That's why I really put setting spray because it just adds like a beautiful finish. It just does it for me. While we're baking and getting all that together, I'm gonna actually get into my lip color and then I'm gonna do my eyes, my brows, and then finish off the look. I'm gonna be showing you guys the lip combo that I have been wearing lately. This is like my go-to natural brown lip. And this will consist of three lip products. So there is a lip liner and then two matte liquid lipsticks. So we're gonna start off first by lining my lips with MAC Cork. This is honestly my favorite brown lip liner. I think I use this in just about every video and every look of mine. Any skin tone can wear it. It's beautiful and wears nicely. It can be worn with matte liquid lipsticks, with gloss, with lipstick. Now I'm gonna go ahead and add on this matte liquid lipstick from NARS. This one is called Slow Ride. Again, another like fire brown matte liquid lipstick. This one right here is an amazing formula, super long lasting, comforting when it's on the lip, doesn't get too dry. I also like the applicator. It's kind of pointy, so it really helps to get in on the cupid's bow of the lip or in the hard to reach areas. All right, so now I'm gonna go ahead and add a little bit of the Dose of Colors matte liquid lipstick in the shade Sand right into the center of the lip. Now, any lip color that's a little lighter is gonna work perfect for this look. You don't have to go as light, but my favorite is using this one. And I also really love the shade Empowered by Jaclyn Hill Cosmetics. And then I also love the NYX Soft Matte Lip Cream in the shade London. All three of those work perfect for this lip. So I'm gonna go ahead and do my brows really quickly off camera. And when I come back, we're gonna get into the eye portion of this makeup look and then finish it off. Brows are done. And if you guys are wondering, I did use the Refi Beauty products on my brows. I actually did them kind of fast, but when I have more time, I will do a more in-depth tutorial for you guys to show you how I do it step by step. Since I'm going to a NARS event, I figured I would use the new NARS products that just came out. So they have this Orgasm on the Beach highlight palette, which I'm gonna hit my cheeks with in just a bit. And then for my eyes, I'm gonna be using the Summer Solstice eyeshadow palette. So this is gonna be like a really easy look to follow along with. Again, perfect for a look like this when the focus is more right here. We just wanna hit a little bit of color onto the eyes. What I'm gonna do is pick up the matte eyeshadow that's right here with this large blending brush, and I'm gonna go right into the center of the eye and then work left and right. I'm gonna go ahead and hit the darker color. Same thing, just gonna go right in the middle of the eye first and then work left and right. I also come to realize that I like doing my eyeshadow in the middle of my eye first versus like in the crease. Something about doing it in the center of my eye, I'm really able to shape it out more. And then when I do it on the crease, I focus so much color here that I feel like it just kind of like loses its shape. So I've been doing it lately like that, like just starting in the center. And I don't know if you guys can see a difference, but I definitely can. Isn't makeup crazy? What difference it does. We're gonna go ahead and hit a little sparkle on my eye. I'm gonna go ahead and use this really sparkly color that's on the palette. I'm gonna show you guys how it looks. It's nice and glittery. I'm gonna go right in the center. Ooh, that is pretty. Same thing on this side. And then just so you guys know, I still have the setting powder underneath. If there is fallout, it's gonna land on that setting powder, but once we buff it out, it will all go away. Now I'm gonna go do a small wing liner with this brown one from Charlotte Tilbury. This one is called Super Brown. I just repurchased it yesterday because I love this eyeliner so much, but here's the colors, you can kind of get an idea. It's not gonna be like a chocolatey dark brown, it's more of like a red terracotta brown. It's hard to explain it, but it's one of my favorites for a daytime brown eyeliner. So I'm gonna start this right at the corner of my eye. I'm gonna do a small wing. And then just a little bit to the inner corner of the eye as well. Wow, it really just like emphasizes the eye shape. I'm gonna go ahead and add some mascara so that by the time I do this eyeliner and I do the mascara, this will be dry and I can pop on my false lash. By the way, this one is from It Cosmetics. It's the Superhero Mascara. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and add lash number one. And what I'm gonna do too is kind of focuses more towards the end of my eye, kind of so that it flares up. And lastly, my look would not be complete if I didn't hit my skin with some highlights. So I'm gonna be using this one from NARS. It's the Orgasm on the Beach Cheek Palette. So I think I'm gonna be using this one and probably the Orgasm one together. And this one, I'm just gonna add it high points of my face. What was that face I just made? Oh my goodness, wow, it's gorgeous. I'm gonna grab a little bit of this one, doing now the Orgasm one over, just to get a little bit more color and a little extra glow. And I think we are, oh, last thing, we need a mascara underneath the eyes. I'm gonna go ahead and jump into my outfit and then come back to show you guys the finished look. All right, so I am all ready for my event. This is the top that I went with. Isn't this so cute? It's from Shop Out. Oh, shit, I'm falling. It is from Allery Collection, which is my girl Ale's line. If you guys haven't checked it out, they have the cutest clothes on there, especially for summertime. And really quickly before I finish off, I'm gonna add a little bit of a body glow because we're gonna be outside and I wanna have a little bit of glow in the shoulders. So I'm gonna be adding this in from Summer Fridays. It's their new body oil. Oh, it smells so good. So I'm gonna hit my shoulders with this. There we go, woo, I love it. It's time to head out of here. I am gonna take you guys along, show you guys little like snippets of the event. And then I also wanna show you guys the makeup in the daytime lighting because I think it just looks so beautiful. And sometimes these lights in here do not do the makeup justice. So with that being said, let's go ahead and get to the event and I'll see you guys there.